You know, the biggest difference would be, I think for me, maturity-wise is the biggest difference, but on the stage that it was presented, I think I did the math and it was 432 days from the last time I put on a Mississippi State jersey to I put on my first jersey in the big leagues, and it happened so quick that the biggest difference to me is just the stage and the amount of people. Although Mississippi State's a great, great fan base and the College World Series was great, it happened that quick, and for me to be out there was an exciting experience for me in Fenway. You know, Thompson and Cohen and Mingione and the whole coaching staff done a great job with every person that's come through this organization. And, you know, the maturity-wise from a freshman year to a senior year, the mentality that I had my freshman year wasn't good. But coming out, I learned how to figure out things on my own. I learned how to grow up and become a man, ultimately, through the coaching staff and the leadership that they have. And then playing in front of, 14,000 fans here and playing in front of the fans that came to Omaha prepared me to get on the stage to make my debut in Boston and in Fenway when there's several thousand more people there cheering and chanting and things like that. So the combination of the coaching staff, the fans have done a great job preparing me for the stage that I was on. Yeah, it's mechanical engineering. It was tough the first couple years, and learning how to time manage was one big thing, but four classes until I graduate, and hopefully one off season, I'll be able to come back and finish that degree. I was a student athlete, so student first, and that was my main goal, was to get a degree. And I loved engineering, I loved every minute of it, but right now baseball is taking over, and hopefully finish that degree sometime in the future. The passion is great everywhere, I'll say everywhere, in the big leagues and here at Duty Noble. There may be a few more number of people at the big league level, but the passion is the same, and maybe even more here at Mississippi State, as to, you get into a close game on a Saturday and how loud it can get with the cowbells and with the amount of people in the stadium. So for me, it prepared me, like I said earlier, it prepared me for that stage and to be on that level. And just to look around and be able to take a deep breath that I learned here, that, hey, your nerves are going to get going sometimes. You're going to get anxious, excited. Just to slow down, take a breath, step off the mound, and prepare myself. And it really is fun playing in front of people here at Duty Noble and also there at the big league level. I think everybody can develop. You wouldn't have looked at me as a freshman or a sophomore and said, wow, that kid, he might be a big leaguer one day. But through work and through the dedication that the coaching staff's put in and the strength coach with Brian Neal has done for us, I think that prepared me over the 4 years to do that. And, with this team, there's a lot of guys that can get outs. And the biggest difference I see from a college level and even minor league level than a professional level at the big league level is how consistent can you be. And if you can be consistent, then people are going to buy into what you do. The biggest thing I miss is the friendships and the lasting relationships that I've made here in Starkville. Growing up, I didn't even consider Mississippi State as an option. I was either Auburn or Alabama growing up in Alabama, but it was a blessing that I was able to come here, and I still stay in contact with numerous people that I've met in Starkville. And I come across people in the airport wearing maroon and white, and I speak to them, Hell State, and just talk to them, and just the family environment that is presented here is one thing that I do miss. Coach Thompson's like, I would always tell people, he's like a second dad to me. Anything that I needed, I remember calling him my freshman year, frustrated as I can be, but him talking me through situations. We weren't very good my freshman year, and ultimately I wasn't very good my freshman year, and I was frustrated. But for him to be a mentor to me, not only on the field, but off the field, is one thing that has really stood out to me, and how he develops relationships with recruits, with players that he coaches, is huge. And as somebody that means the world to me, and I'll do anything for him. And like I said, he's almost like a second dad. I'll tell him that, it was a great experience. It was something that I wouldn't trade for anything. And it was a better experience because we helped get a program that was not doing so well back to where it needs to be. And the past couple years is what Mississippi State baseball is all about. And just to be a part of that, just one small piece of that, is one thing that I'll hold on to and hold a little pride to, and be able to tell my kids one day that, hey, we were runners up in the College World Series. We wanted to finish the thing, but to get back on that stage and to turn that program around was huge. I'd say thank you for the support. It's been unbelievable. Even the support when we were here, it's something that doesn't compare at other places. And I can say that honestly and as truthfully as I can be. And you know, just the fan base that we have here come out and just to continue to support this team. They support us through the good times and through the bad times. And those people that you can really respect that come out when you're 6-24 like we were in the SEC my freshman year, that stuck with us, and to see the smiles on their faces when we were contending in Omaha is one thing that I always remember.